How Tara? I'm joking. But if you are asked to think about, if I tell you a joke, then you won't go to sleep. But if I'm seriously talking, then do you feel happy or bored?
Bored.
See? Unless you love God, you always feel really
bored.
Yeah? If you go to a temple, very quiet, and you are asked to sit and meditate, do you like it? You will always go to a temple where there is a lot of, you know, singing, dancing, people, etc., etc. Anyway, what is the point you are taking? If you are progressing towards God, how do we measure our progress? In? You are growing in?
Satchitananda.
Not only that, it's a very important point. Very important point. People don't even often understand that. If you are not good, are you a wise person? If you are not a wise person, can you be a happy person? Who can be called a happy person? A wise person. And who is a wise person? Only a good person. Only a good person. This is very difficult for people to swallow because they think by hook or crook, I will earn money and I will try to be happy. So if I ask you this question, honestly, can a wicked person be really happy?
No.
Don't give me bookish answer.
No.
Really, give answer me from your hearts.
If that's their goal in life, yes. If that's their goal in life, yes.
That's all they want to do. That's all makes them happy.
You see, that's why I said it's one of the most difficult things for us to understand. Only a good person can be a happy person. A person may have pleasure. Your money can bring you pleasure. But it can never make you a happy person. And that too, your pleasure is for a very, very short time. If you want to be happy, then it should be something very pervasive. You can't simply say, for 1 minute I am happy. That is, you can be happy. That is not called happiness, that is called pleasure. You know, you eat some sweet or you drink, then you are temporarily, for a few minutes, you are happy. But not, that is not real happy. Real happiness means you should be fully conscious and you should have your own control of mind, and that is the only happiness. But people, they want very shortcut, quick happiness, you know, instant happiness. That is why nowadays everything is instant. Instant coffee,
instant noodles,
everything instant. And so their happiness also will be
instant.
How long instant noodle lasts?
2 minutes or 1 minute.
Yeah. That is the truth. Okay. What is the fourth sentence that Swami Vivekananda said? You know what he said? Books, temples, churches, doctrines, dogmas, these are all secondary details. What is the primary detail? You should believe you are potentially
divine.
And you should have the goal that let me manifest my inner divinity. And what is the way to manifest that divinity? Through the practice of any of the four yogas. And so the fourth sentence is very important because suppose there are two persons. One person goes to temple, but very wicked. Another person doesn't go to any temple doesn't put any marks, religious marks on his person, but he is very loving, very unselfish. Whom do you trust?
Unselfish person.
See, we all instinctively we want to go to a person who doesn't tell a lie. And if we want to go to a person who is good, who doesn't have any hidden motives, and who is always wishing our welfare, and also who is a happy person. Is it not?
Yes.
So, now let us summarize what Hinduism